one student. That, as you know, last day I already discussed, start a new chapter. The chapter 11 is known as the simple machine. And I discussed what is the definition of simple machine and what are the two types of simple machine and why we should need the simple machine. So what is a simple machine? The simple machine is a type of machine that is help us to do our work very easily within the lazy flow. Now, today we are going to discuss about the types of simple machine. Now, machines are two types, simple and complex. Now, today we are going to discuss about the different types of simple machine. And the first one is the lever. So, what is the lever? That lever is a reed rod or bar that rests on a support is called the fulcrum. And the lever, you can see in your book, there is a given the picture in the page number 106. That here the one person that pull the by the one stick that want to pull this stone, but while is a fulcrum is being absent, only the people sticks are given the effort and the load is present, but in between the fulcrum is absent in the middle portion, that time he want need to keep the more pressure to pull or to remove the stone from one place to another place. But you see in the second picture that the person, if in middle, between the person and the stone, if middle one the small stone also, but the fulcrum is being present, that time what happened? That time the people no need to keep the more effort and it can easily remove the stone from one place to the another place. Then by this way, that the fulcrum is necessary for the three things. The three things is very necessary for the lever. What are the three things? That the first one is the load. L that we represent by the L. Second one is the effort that we represent by through the E. And the third one is the fulcrum. The fulcrum that is represented by the F. So these are the main three things, the main three parts of a lever. And the load means the how much the load is there, and the effort means how much effort the given by the things. And the third is the fulcrum means the maintain the balance between these two. Now, today we are going to discuss about the what are the different types of lever. Now, the levers are three types. What are the three types? First is the class 1 lever, second class 2 lever, and third class 3 lever. First is the lever are three types. First class 1 lever, second class 2 lever, and third class 3 lever. Now, one by one we have to discuss. First class 1 lever. That in which type of lever? That fulcrum is located in the middle. Fulcrum is located in the between of load and effort. This type of lever is known as class 1 lever. What is the class 1 lever? That in which type of lever that fulcrum is located between the load and effort. This type of lever is known as class 1 lever. And the example of the class 1 levers is the scissors or the seesaw. These are the example of the class 1 lever. Now the next one, class 2 lever. That the load is located between the effort and fulcrum. Load is located between the effort and fulcrum. This type of the lever is known as class 2 lever. What is the example of the class 2 lever? Is the bottle openers, nutcrackers. That are the example of the class 2 lever. Now the third one is the class 3 lever. That is the effort is located between the load and fulcrum. This type of the lever is known as class 3 lever. What is the class 3 lever? That in which type of lever that effort is located between the load and fulcrum. This type of lever is known as class 3 lever. And the example of the class 3 levers is the tongs or the fishing rods. These are the example of the class 3 lever. Now again I discuss the levers are three types. Class 1 lever, class 2 lever, class 3 lever. Now class 1 lever first. That in which type of lever fulcrum is located between the load and effort. This type of lever is known as class 1 lever. And the example of class 1 lever, that is the scissors. Now the next is class 2 lever. That the load is located between the fulcrum and effort. Load is located between the fulcrum and effort. This type lever is known as class 2 lever. And the example is the nutcrackers, bottle openers. These are the example of class 2 lever. And the third one is the class 3 lever, that when the effort is located between the load and effort, between the load and fulcrum, that is known as the class 3 lever. And the example is the tongs or the fishing rods, and the example of class 3 lever. So these are the different parts, and one thing is you notice that only the middle portion is being changed every time, in every lever portion, in the three levers, that the middle portion is being changed. In the first class or the class 1 lever, that the fulcrum is located in middle. In the second class lever, that is the load is located in middle. And the class 3 lever, effort is located in middle. So these three are being changed. So by this way, you have to learn with all the three different types of lever, definition of lever, and with their proper example. So today, up here, next day I discuss more about the simple machine. Thank you.